Hey everyone, so continuing the series of grading every candidate for joining the Straw Hat Crew, today we are at our final candidate, and it's one most of you probably didn't expect, unless you've been a longtime Morge viewer, and that's Smoker. Was this whole series an elaborate build up to this video, where I can finally explain why Smoker is practically guaranteed to be a Straw Hat? Who knows? Yes. That's not to say that none of the other candidates will be joining, and next week I will also be giving the final rundown of what the endgame Straw Hat crew will look like. But first, I have to convince you all of Smoker. So, for these past videos, we've been going off of criteria. The five main things I've been looking at are a dream, sad backstory, potential role in the crew, a major character conflict to be resolved, and whether or not it makes sense for the character's direction in the story. Obviously, there are no official rules for what a character needs to be in order to be a Straw Hat. But these are some general commonalities that I have been looking at, along with other factors. If you want an explanation of why these five criteria matter, I suggest checking out the start of the Yamato video, where I explain more in depth, and the link is in the description below. But with Smoker, it's a little different, because this character has been around for a long, long time. The more the story has gone on, the more signs have seemed to point, to me at least, that this was a character written from the start to be a Straw Hat. Certainly the most unexpected Straw Hat, but a Straw Hat. Because as of right now, it's really not clear to a lot of readers why he was written, and why he's been such a mainstay in the story. It should be very clear to everyone at this point by now that Smoker is not meant to be Luffy's Garp. I did a whole video in the past on this before. The link is in the description if you want a detailed explanation. If you want to skip all that, then forget it all, right? Let's just consider how little sense it makes if the guy that was getting whooped by Virgo last we saw is in any way meant to be a rival to Luffy, or even close to him in strength at this point. Like, it's pretty clear who Luffy's main enemy in the Marines is. Now, if you want to say Smoker was written so that we could see that there are good guys in the Marines as well, then now I'd say you're onto something, but I personally think it's a lot more than that. So, one of the most important themes in the story is the idea of what justice really is. Who is justice, who are the criminals, and how these ideas are not as black and white as one would initially think. That is, of course, what this entire speech was about, that labels such as pirates and marines are actually meaningless, as they're not representative of who is actually justice, but rather simply which party has power at a given time. If one party has power, then they are justice. If the enemy gains more power, then they become justice. The pirates of today can easily be the marines of tomorrow, if the balance of power shifts, as whoever is in charge writes the rules. Doflamingo's speech spells it out for us, but that is what we are also shown throughout the story, over and over again. That's literally the story of Dressrosa, where overnight, pirates became the righteous, just government, and the righteous, just government became criminals. It's happening right now in Wano, where the Kozuki are now known as criminals, and traitors like Orochi and pirates like Kaido are considered to be the rightful authority. I go more in depth regarding this theme in my video on the philosophy of One Piece, and the depth of how Oda layers this messaging throughout the story is actually incredible. I'm really just skimming through it here, but the basic point is this is a philosophy that we are fed over and over, that the labels are just that. They're labels. They don't actually reflect the truth. The Marines are not justice simply because they claim to be justice, and pirates are not evil simply because they are labeled evil. And cool. That's a nice idea we can all easily get behind, but the most powerful way to truly show the reader this idea is through this character. And I believe that that is very much the reason that Smoker was created. Who is Smoker? What are the ideals that define him? And what has been his character arc in the story so far? Smoker, upon his introduction, is defined by a very few straightforward ideals. He's a hardcore Marine who believes strongly in the importance of justice, and he absolutely hates pirates. Smoker is the model example of the typical pirate-hating Marine. He obviously thinks for himself, but he certainly subscribes to the belief that all pirates are bad, and that the Marine side is the side of justice. What has been his character arc so far? What is the purpose of him interacting with Luffy over and over and being such a mainstay in the story? And specifically, why is it so important that Smoker's main arcs that he's been involved in have been arcs where nations need to be saved by pirates? Like, Smoker's not in Thriller Bark, he's not in any Slobby. His main storylines were Alabasta and Dressrosa. Each time Smoker is in an extended storyline with Luffy, He sees that there are great injustices happening, and Smoker himself is incapable of stopping it. The Marines are incapable of stopping it. The ones who do actually bring that justice that Smoker values so highly are pirates. By the end of Alabasta, Smoker has his first sort of eye-opening moment where he's seen that the world government is really the ones responsible for all this by having Shichibukai, and the world government is still trying to cover all of this up, while the ones who did what was right from the start were the Straw Hats. In the Dressrosa storyline, it starts with Punk Hazard, with Smoker first of all working with pirates to do what's right, and simultaneously realizing that it's the Marines themselves who are responsible for everything that's happening on this island. The Dressrosa storyline ends with him realizing that once again, just like in Alabasta, it was the Straw Hat Pirates who were able to bring justice, while the Marines were useless in doing so, and actually were part of the problem. So point being that Smoker's character arc so far has been that at each turn, realizing that the Marines and his side are not necessarily justice, and similarly realizing that pirates can in fact be the ones who bring justice. So basically each time his faith in the Marines and the world government diminishes a little bit, whereas his respect for the Straw Hats and what they do goes up. Now, it still might seem really extreme to think that, oh, well, Smoker is going to just, you know, up and leave the Marines to join the Straw Hats, but here's the thing. First of all, the Punk Hazard arc arguably has some seriously heavy foreshadowing for his character. By the end of the arc, Smoker is literally sitting side by side with Law with this line between them. It's the literal line between pirates and Marines. In the grand scheme of things, that line and what it means is a huge deal. But here, in this arc, the point is that it's so easily crossed. The Marines and pirates have worked together this entire time, and it's ending with this line literally being crossed as Marines flock over to the pirate side. The fact that this arc ends with Smoker literally sitting right next to the line, having spent the entire arc working with pirates and seeing how much evil there actually is in the Marines, is not meaningless. And on top of that, the very next scene Smoker has is with Awakiji, who himself has left the Marines, but who, as Doflamingo points out, still clearly has some sort of purpose or goal in life. And Awakiji literally tells Smoker that you can accomplish many things without being in the Marines, and that many things become clear after leaving the Marines. So to be clear, we have an entire arc where Smoker works with pirates, sees the good in the pirates he works with, and sees the evil in the Marines. The arc ends with some heavy symbolism of the line between good and evil, Marines and pirates, yet also showing how easily that line is crossed and how the labels are actually meaningless, with Smoker literally sitting side by side with a pirate at the end of it, divided only by this meaningless line. And then finally, Smoker is told by Awakiji of the benefits of leaving the Marines, the things that you can accomplish after leaving the Marines, and your change in perspective. So at this point, you might be thinking that, okay, maybe there are hints that Smoker does ultimately leave the Marines, but that doesn't mean he has to actually become a pirate. That feels too drastic, right? And even if he does leave, he doesn't have to become a Straw Hat. He could, you know, be his own independent party like Awakiji, or maybe even join the Straw Hat Grand Fleet, but it just feels too weird to think that Smoker would join the crew. No, that's the point. That's the point of his character, at least as I believe makes sense, based on everything the series is about. The fact that some of you might still think it's too drastic for a hardcore Marine like Smoker to become a pirate, let alone a Straw Hat pirate, means that the series' philosophy has not yet been hammered home enough. And that's also precisely why Smoker becoming a pirate may have been part of Oda's plan to hammer in that philosophy, that the labels don't matter. They're not real. Marines and pirates are fluid, nebulous terms. They change on a dime. The people in the One Piece world put too much stock in them. That's the point, but they don't mean what people think they mean. Because what defines Smoker at his core, at the end of the day, is not that he's a Marine. What defines Smoker is his desire for justice. The point is that all along, he's under the misconception that justice and Marines are synonymous, when in reality, they have nothing to do with one another. True justice is independent of labels like Marines and Pirates. And that's what his character arc is, shattering the illusion that labels like Marines or Pirates have anything to do with justice. Once that realization is complete, then Smoker should not think anything of getting on a pirate's ship, because at that point, he would realize that that label carries no weight. He would be getting on the ship of the crew that regularly brings actual justice to the world, and that's all that matters. And if Smoker is leaving the Marines, then I don't think it's enough for him to become, you know, an independent party like Awakiji. I don't think it's enough for him to join just the Grand Fleet. think the character and his character arc and what it means with regards to the themes of the story only truly carries weight if he actually joins the Straw Hat Crew themselves, because that is the ultimate demonstration of this idea. Introduce a character who from the start is the most anti-pirate, justice-loving Marine there is. Over time, having repeatedly realized that the pirate and Marine sides of the equation don't matter, that justice is completely independent of those labels, and ultimately complete that character arc by taking him over that line to the other side, going from the absolutist who felt he had to chase this crew no matter what, to ultimately sailing with this crew in the end. That's a character arc that commits to showing this message all the way through. And now you might be saying, okay, that sounds kinda good, but it's still too big of a jump for his actual character. Like, why would Smoker ever decide to join the Straw Hats? And that's a good question. First of all, I acknowledge that where Smoker is at now, which is very respectful and impressed by the Straw Hats, and generally very mistrusting of the world government, is still a far cry from actually quitting the Marines and asking to join the Straw Hat crew. But the point is, he's been set up with the right mindset. It's basically getting the character in place, and then all that's needed is a push. Where we're at right now, all that's needed for Smoker to join the crew are two things. First, an event that completely shatters what little faith he has left in the world government and makes him see it as the ultimate enemy of justice in the world, which it is. So first, that eye-opening event. Second, something that makes him realize that the Straw Hat ship is where he needs to be in order to rectify everything that the world government has done wrong to the world. And over the last couple hundred chapters, I think we've got enough evidence for both of these things to happen. First of all, forget Smoker. I think most of us imagine an endgame of the story where every country the Straw Hats have saved or made friends with comes to join their fight against the world government, right? Like, we're probably going to have Alabasta and Dressrosa and Fishman Island fighting alongside them, and so on, right? So why would those countries join Luffy? Like, if Luffy said today, hey everyone, we're declaring war on the world government, it would be really, really weird for all of these countries to come together and just, like, attack the government. Like, Alabasta's not just gonna attack the government because Luffy says so, that's not happening. The reality is there needs to be a worldwide catalyst for a lot of people, a lot of nations and so on, to open their eyes and see the world government for what it is. From there, it would make sense that a revolution would start. But we've already been told that this major catalyst event is coming. The Gorosei outright said that they're going to do a great cleansing. Something is going to happen, something big and terrible for a lot of people, that is going to open up a lot of eyes. I'm willing to bet that Smoker's eye-opening moment where he resigns is this great cleansing. For a character who is already so disillusioned with the Marines and the world government, one catastrophic, eye-opening event is all that is needed. That's the big push. Now, the second side of it. Why would he join the Straw Hats? Well, these last couple arcs we've been getting set up for this idea that the Straw Hats are the ones who are predicted to be the ones who will bring the dawn of the world, and more people are starting to see them that way. I think we can assume that the dawn of the world means a sort of better future, a rebirth, a new era, or a new system, and the end of the previously broken and unjust system of the world government. I think we are set up for this arc, Wano, to be the one where the dawn of the world, or what needs to be done, becomes more clear, as we are in One Piece's final phase at this point. Meaning that all that needs to happen for Smoker is to once again see the Straw Hats, you know, again get one big, seemingly impossible victory over evil as they will by the end of the Wano arc, for Smoker to see the world government for the evil it truly is once it begins the Great Cleansing, which in turn would make him quit, and then lastly to find out something either related to the dawn of the world or that some secret of how the world can be changed is waiting at Rafto. That last part is a bit of a question mark, I understand. You know, how would Smoker learn about the dawn of the world or realize that the secret to changing the world would be in Rafto? But I think a lot of it fits if Smoker is present in Wano by the end of the Wano arc. And I think that's completely possible, as I and many others believe the Marines will be coming to Wano by the end of the arc. If Smoker is one of the Marines who comes, then a lot of things fall into place. The world government, you know, they want to try out their new weapon, so I could easily imagine Smoker witnessing or learning about the Great Cleansing as it's happening while he's in Wano. If Smoker is in Wano, he gets to witness the Straw Hats again, for a third time, defeating a great evil that the Marines could not, and bringing justice to the land again. And finally, it gives Smoker an opportunity to learn a bit about the world and potentially realize the world government needs to be torn down, and that the secret to a better world can supposedly be found by sailing with this crew to the last island of the Grand Line. So a lot is contingent on Smoker ending up in Wano, but I don't think that's that unlikely. And more importantly, everything about his character arc so far to me suggests that all along he was written to show us, you know, a hardcore Marine become a pirate himself as he is awakened to the truth of the world and the true nature of justice. So, I know I just spent a lot of time talking about Smoker's character conflict and his potential direction, but all that aside, here let's just talk about the other criteria. I don't think Smoker has a dream that he's made clear, but his main drive is for justice, and if the world government were to be exposed for evil, then it would be a pretty easy transition for his ultimate goal to be for a system of crew justice to be put in place. It fits perfectly with his character. As for role in the crew, I've always felt that Smoker would be a perfect military strategist for them, as the Straw Hats are pretty soon going to be commanding lots more subordinates and fleets and such during the final war, and Smoker has always shown himself to be a smart and strategic character, plus obviously professional military experience commanding lots of Marines. As for sad backstory, this is where it's interesting. The only thing we know about Smoker's childhood is that he was present for the Pirate King's execution. We never learned how that impacted him or what he thought of it, only that he was present for it and that Luffy later on reminded him of it. I think just in general, with Smoker's strong drive for justice and the fact that he witnessed such a historic moment as a child, means that there's a lot of potential for an interesting backstory, like what shaped him and how was that moment related to it. Maybe not necessarily a tragic backstory, but at the very least, one that strongly shaped who he is today. But all of that stuff isn't as important as his character conflict and character direction, because to me, those seem so ridiculously strongly in favor of him becoming a Straw Hat that it just trumps everything else. And so for Smoker's grade, I'm going to be giving him, you guessed it, an A++. Anything less would be disrespectful, anything more would be excessive. If you agree or disagree, then comment below, and if you enjoyed this video, then definitely like and subscribe, and you can support me on Patreon for extended thoughts on this and all future topics. My prediction for the complete final crew will be next week, so watch out for that.